Hi there, I'm High Voice bringing you a technique to set breakpoints on a native process using a search. As we begin, a gentle reminder to subscribe and hit that bell icon to be notified of new videos. This really helps me know the kind of content to produce next. So let's get into it. This is by no means the only or best way to set a breakpoint, but I use this technique often as it's simple to do. We start by launching a native process. I have included a link to the source code of the process in the description below. Select File, Launch Executable, then select the executable to launch. This executable we are debugging does not do anything particularly interesting. Rather, it was created as an example for attaching breakpoints. Once WinDebug has stopped at the initial breakpoint, verify that symbols have loaded. A simple technique to verify that symbols have loaded is to run lm to list modules, then lmvm on the executable module. If symbols are loaded, then the path to the symbols will be present. We start by searching through the symbols for the name of the function we would like to attach the breakpoint. Type x followed by the name of the symbol. The full syntax of the symbol is as follows. Start with the name of the module, followed by an exclamation, then the name of the class and function. It is possible to use wildcards, so we will use some wildcards for an easier match. Once the command is run, the function address will be presented. We can then set a breakpoint on the function address. Set the breakpoint using BP. BP sets a resolved breakpoint. This breakpoint is set on all threads, so it will stop the process when hit. There is also an unresolved breakpoint BU, which will be covered later in the video. We can view the list of breakpoints via BL. The list is presented with an index. This index is used if we want to disable, enable, clear, or change a breakpoint. Disable a breakpoint via BD with an index. The index can be a wildcard. Enable a breakpoint via BE with an index. The index can be a wildcard. I will skip changing a breakpoint until later in the video. Press F5 to run the process. Let me click this button to trigger the breakpoint. When a breakpoint is hit, WinDebug will present the command bar. We can view the index of the breakpoint along with the registers. The EIP register will have the memory address of the function. This, as you can see, is a 32-bit process. At this point, other commands can be run to debug. For example, run kb to view the stack and dv to view local variables. We can assign commands to be run when a breakpoint is hit. We do this by entering the command after the BP in quotes. Let's set the breakpoint again, but this time with the string k1g, which will display one line of stack and then continue. We have now set a breakpoint that works like a trace point. Hit break to break into the process. Run BL to view the breakpoints. Run BS to change the breakpoint to echo a string. The command run in a breakpoint can even be used to enable or disable other breakpoints. For example, BD*G is a valid breakpoint command. Finally, clear the breakpoint using BC with an index. BC clears breakpoints. BC can be used with a wildcard. There is another kind of breakpoint, the unresolved breakpoint. Unresolved breakpoints are set on symbols rather than a specific memory address. Set an unresolved breakpoint via BU with the full symbol name. The unresolved symbol is used most often when setting on a module that has not been loaded yet. I do not use BU as much as there are other techniques which I find simpler than setting unresolved breakpoints. There is one more kind of break which is useful, which is a break for an exception. View the list of exceptions via SX. Some of the more interesting exceptions are the initial breakpoint IBP, Common Language Runtime CLR, and Access Violation AV. Enable an exception break via SXE. Run SXE AV. Now run the process and trigger the exception. Observe the break is similar to a breakpoint. Here is a useful technique to avoid unresolved breakpoints. Run SXE LD module to break when a module is loaded. At that point, you can then proceed to add resolved breakpoints. These techniques can be adapted to be used on managed processes. I will cover .NET in a future video. So, this is the technique I use when setting breakpoints. Let me know in the comments if you know this technique or have used it before. As always, if you like what you see and would like to support the channel, give us a like, subscribe and comment below. Until next time, I'm High Voice, signing out.